So behind the greenhouse here, we have this little brooder here where the ducks are going to be coming over. And we're going to break the fence here, make a cut in it right here at this post, and kind of enclose this area for them to where they can have this area here, have the brooder under the shade of this oak tree, and then they can also get into the garden that will be fenced and gated off and be able to go to work. And their work is eat the bugs in the garden. Now, ducks are great for the garden because their poop is great fertilizer for it, and they do not eat fruit and vegetables. They'll leave your produce alone. They're going after flower seed and grass and any bug they can find. So they're going to go through all these plants, they're going to pick all the bugs off of them for you, and they're going to keep it healthy, and they'll eat down this grass. That's what they naturally eat, so it's going to be great for them. We'll get some water out here, fix this up a little bit, and they'll be real happy in this. They'll be safe, they'll be sheltered, they'll be able to lay their eggs in their own nest and not have any of our turkeys or chickens get in there and break those eggs so we can start hatching some ducks. We could put them in the brooder, but we have noticed that they do not accept them when they're hatched in the brooder and fights break out. There's old Mr. Max. And so now I'm going to come over here by the wood mill where we have over 30 logs on the ground and a lot more coming. Down here in Texas, it's been over 100 degrees almost every day in June. We're now June 30th and right at 100 degrees. So it's starting to cool off. But we have cedar logs on the ground drying in this heat, so that's a good thing. I just got this today, so all these logs, I just cut these today and cleared them out. And so that's today's work that I got done. About 10 o'clock we stopped because the heat's too hot. So 10 o'clock in the morning I stopped. No more physical work out there. You can get burnt up in the sun real, real bad. But we got some good size cedar over here. And this is mainly what I'm after, is really large cedar like this. I like this good size cedar here. I'm not really looking for the smaller ones like that, but these cedars were by a creek that it was requested that we target them because there was a broken fence. And I'm going to mend that fence for them tomorrow. I'm going to repair a patch where their cattle have been getting out for them. And I had to get all these trees out. Plus, they want every cedar out of there because they're highly allergic to it. And these cedars have dried up their creek. Not no more. Going to be turned into furniture. So more cedars over here. Some of these are just going to be fence posts. They're too small, obviously. And so when I say 30 logs on the ground, I'm counting millable logs only. Only the millable logs, which are these large ones. This is not worth putting on the mill. This one right here, I could get a couple of boards out of it, you know, but that's it. This one here, that's going on the far corner right here, that one will not go on the mill. Neither will this one right here. It's just too small. These three over here will. That one and that chunk over there, I'll make some small boards out of it, you know. This first one right here will not go on the mill, but the rest of these logs will. These are real good size. And this is basically what you want to find when you take a cedar down. This is close to the end of a cedar. These are not pine trees. They don't get real wide like big pine trees do. So like this size cedar right here that's growing, I'm using it for shade right now. As long as it grows healthy and no problems, it will probably stay there. I don't know yet, but this is a perfect cedar. It's growing really nice, very straight, and that's what you're looking for when you go to put something on a mill. This is what I want to find. I want to find this size and larger to put on there. Do have some dead oaks that we're going to be taking out just because they keep dropping branches. I keep cleaning them up. They're all sitting in the fire pit over there ready to burn. It's just too hot to have a fire right now. More dead oaks over there. Another one right here that we'll be taking down and getting out of there. There are a few over here. We had a real hard frost the last winter, and we had 2 years of really hard drought. And believe it or not, we are in a drought right now. So we have to get those dead trees out of there and clean it all up. This fall, Hope is out there eating grass right now. It is starting to brown up a little bit, believe it or not. There's been a little moisture in the morning, and this grass is drought tolerant. It knows how to grow in drought conditions. It's used to it down here in South Central Texas. But come July, this all goes brown. July and August, the fields turn brown. And then in the fall, they come back green for one more time right before winter. And that's where everybody gets their final cut of grass. So this Wood Miser LX25, it's the smallest sawmill that they actually make, but it does the job and it mills up all these logs. And so we've got a blade on there now. It's a little bit rusty. I'll try cleaning it up, seeing how it does on one of the smaller logs. I'll test out the blade, see if she's good. She's been sitting on there for about a couple of seasons now. But yeah, they last a long time cutting cedar. You go into oak, your blades don't last that long. This will be operational and I'll make videos of it. I have some already of me running this. As you can see, we've made quite a bit of sawdust. So that's good. Yep, we use the sawdust in the garden and all around the property for the nesting of the birds. They like to take dust baths in it. We have a lot of oak firewood here we'll be burning in our large fire pit coming up this fall and this winter. And it looks like I need to make some new benches. I don't know, these old logs look like they've had it. Been out here about 3 years now, or 2 years, I don't know, I forget. But they've been seasoned out, so it's time to make some real good permanent chairs and benches around here. And some of these are actually still stumps. So that's a stump, and that one over there by the fence is a stump. The rest are not stumps, they're part of that one out that were. Terminator Tom out here with all the rest of our turkeys. I think we're like at 25 turkeys right now. We had 30, we lost a few. There has been an owl that has been coming down preying on our small turkeys and small chickens. So we have a cattle panel in front here that we close at night, and I'm going to be putting up some netting from the top of the barn door all the way down, and that will block that off and prevent the owl from coming in, because these guys he's not bothering. They're too big. It's those little ones that he's going after right there. And she's probably a little too big right now too. So we just got to watch some of these other smaller ones. You see, they all come running because they think I have food for them. Once one runs, they all run, and the slowly will start coming and being observant of, like, why is everybody running over there? And then they see me and they're like, oh, he's feeding us. And no, I'm not. I'm just making a video. False alarm. I did not make the whistle. Now, if I whistle, they'll all come running. So we still, what are we up to? We're down to 7 goats. And there's Terminator Tom, one of our original turkeys. He's the only turkey that got pardoned each year. All the other turkeys were processed. And we're just keeping him around to see what he does. Of course, we're gonna have problems when some of these other toms get a little bit bigger and start challenging him. Right now, he's too big to challenge. But they're growing up. They're growing up fast. And come November, we'll have some turkey sales where we'll get rid of some of them, process some for ourselves. I know, it's terrible, but you're bound for the freezer. Don't peck the goat. Goaty girl didn't like that, did you? Okay, little babies down there. Growing up, hurry up and grow up. There you go. All right, guys, well, that's just a little bit of an update out here about what's going on the homestead, what we've got going here on our ranch. The wood operation of it all. We've got to take out some. All right, yeah, that's it for now. I'm gonna go back inside because it is hot. Goats are back there foraging in some opened weed area that I opened up and extended the fence out that way. All in all, right here, they've probably got a little over an acre right now that they get to free range on. Eventually, we're gonna open up the back 8 acres for them as well. And maybe go behind the sawmill and over here. But it's getting too hot. I'm going back inside. So thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next update. God bless.